terrorism and the ideologies that drives terrorism and violence extremism is opportunistic in nature. It will take advantage of certain situations within community. If you want to address it, you have to address the issue of corruption.
What makes you to shift from radicalism to extremism is the level of grievances that you have and the fact that you don't believe that there's no other way than violence that can make you to come back. People don't, they don't conceive the possibility of somebody who has been radicalized to come back, to be de-radicalized. It's a very important issue because it means that all the solutions are mainly security solutions.
So violent extremism can be defined as political ideologies that oppose a society's core values and principles. It can also be used to describe the methods through which political actors attempt to realize their aims. That is, by using means that show disregard for the life, liberty, and human rights of others. So based on this definition, basically violent extremism can be basically broken down into three broad categories. It could be issue-based, so, you know, environmental protection, animal rights, anti-gun control. It could be political, religious, ideological, and this is basically what we have been talking about since this morning. And in addition to, you know, Islamic cult groups, there are also Christian, radical Christian groups, Zionist movements, et cetera, et cetera. And it can also be political separatist groups such as the ETA, Basque, IRA, et cetera.
We have push and pull factors when you talk about issues of violent extremism. What are some of the push factors? Social marginalization, poor governance, government repressions, corruption and elite impunity, just like Sheikh Lithome highlighted earlier, cultural threat perceptions and all these things. And then we have pull factors, which is, or could comprise of, social status and respect from peers, a sense of belonging, adventure, self-esteem, influence of radical institutions, extremist involvement in economy, etc.